This week we are in Nairobi and we organize a new town lab on the new town of Tatu City. We are based in Rotterdam and we are a worldwide think and do tank on new towns. So what we try to do is try to connect research with the practice of new town. And we are here with a group of Dutch experts. It's an interdisciplinary team. And we are working on the question how to make a connected framework from the green and blue spaces within Tatu City. So how that can be used as a backbone to make Tatu City a more inclusive new town.
Welcome. We are very appreciative for Tatu City to be in the label of Tatu City. Tatu City have done much for us, and we expect more from Tatu City.
Ni mtoto wangu ya kwanza anaitwa Peter Ngoge, alizaliwa Kimei ugonjwa wake tangu akiwa mtoto, na shida yake ni ya CP, cerebral palsy. Hii kiti walimpea juzi hii mwezi ya nane ikiisha, ndio hawa watu wa Tatu City walikuja wakamkuta akiwa pale akiwa hawezi kutoka juu. Alikuwa na kakiti kingine kamzee, akienda anatambia, mimi nasikia vizuri sana.
Tatu City atatusaidia na hawa wako hapa, tupate press ya kuchengea hawa watoto. Hata hawa wengine wako hapa hawana kazi. Unajua sehemu pale ikichengwa, si hata hawa wengine wataanza kosi singine huko. Ndio sasa tuone kama hii kijiji yetu itaendelea. Ndio tunaomba Tatu City, hata nyinyi kama huyu gentleman. You are smart.
So as a development manager again, I do not have a specific precinct that I work on. I work on the whole of Tatu City. How do I bring the city to life, the whole city? So of course, yes, as I mentioned earlier, the blue spaces are keen for us because we use them also as an infrastructure component. The green spaces, if well maintained and if well planned, if well developed, actually used as recreational spaces. I know in some instances in the country in general, or rather here in Kenya, they become hazardous because people don't think of how will they be maintained, how they'll be built, and they tend to become areas of squatting or areas that become generally unsafe. But at Tatu, we actually turn that into an advantage and create them as interesting spaces to enhance lifestyle here at Tatu.
Yes, of course there are a few disadvantages. Number one being that there is existing natural vegetation around the green spaces. There is existing animal life, like the hippos that we have in the dams, and they move in between the dams. So our intervention in bringing human life into the city is obviously going to interfere with the natural vegetation and the wildlife that is existing in the area.
Well, what we are actually hoping to get to is a list of recommendations indeed, but it's very much a way of understanding what is still hidden as potentials in the plan that people maybe not have discovered yet. Because it's so huge, we believe that there's a lot of treasures to be found in the project.
What we can expect from the week is a strategy to go forward that Tatu City can adopt with all its partners and with INTI supporting them, to look at how we can connect the parts of Tatu City that are already that are already developed, already designed for, and look at how to create an experience as a city for the people that are buying into the city and for the people already existing around it.